Que se escuche ese ruido, que se escuche ese ruido. Let me hear you make some noise. Let me hear you make some noise. Ah, 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 haga ruido. Ah, 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 haga ruido.
How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to Haga Ruido. I'm Tony Haga, your host.
And I am Nina, your co-host. And today we have a very special guest with us. Well, a lot of them. We got Los Rodriguez de Nuevo León.
Welcome, guys. Welcome, bienvenidos.
Today we have, who do we have today?
First guest.
My name is Denise, and I'm a, HR.
HR.
Slash manager.
Okay.
And then I'm Senor Hernandez.
Hola, mis amigos. Yo soy José Hernández Rodríguez. Y pues muchas gracias por la invitación. Estamos aquí con los integrantes de Los Rodríguez de Nuevo León. Y pues yo toco el bajo aquí con ellos, ¿verdad? Y pues soy subcontractor electricista.
Nice. Ok.
Mi nombre es Brisa y también formo parte del grupo Rodríguez y soy la acordeonista.
Jay.
Yo soy Benito Nieves, soy el ingeniero del grupo y a.k.a. Benny Blanco from the Bronx, sound engineer.
Yes.
Hello, my name is Adrian Rodriguez. I'm a bajo player and primera voz.
Hello, my name is Alexis Sierra, and I seem to be one of the new singers.
Welcome.
My name is Joe Rodriguez. I'm the singer and the whole instruments that anybody needs to play.
Back up.
Okay.
Sí, bueno, yo soy Juan Rodriguez, el papá de los pollitos. Bueno, más para que los sepan y vayan y digan. Y soy el animador de los Rodríguez de Nuevo León. Ahí para todos ustedes. Y aquí estamos para servirles a todos por ahí. Que nos estén mirando por ahí, que nos vayan a mirar.
Échale mi nomás. Somos de los Rodríguez de Nuevo León. I'm Justin, a.k.a. El Gallo Rojo. Gallo Rojo, pongas. For los Rodríguez de Nuevo León slash professions.
Gallo Rojo. Slash grito, guy.
Tengo un grito también.
Daniel Rodríguez, baterista y vocalista de Los Rodríguez.
Nice. Welcome everybody to our podcast.
So we just finished shooting a whole
live
performance with the Rodríguez. These guys killed it. Hicieron
buen trabajo todos. Congratulations, guys. It was successful.
Muchas gracias. And ¿cuántas canciones tocamos? Like.
About 10 songs.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. I was passing out.
All stressed and nervous.
¿Y cómo están todos? ¿Bien? ¿Bien? ¿Everybody's doing good? Yeah?
Yeah. All good. How's everybody's good? Good?
All good.
Yeah. All right. It's Saturday, so it was good.
All right.
Y aquí todos casi son hermanos, ¿verdad? Everyone's brothers here. Right,
brother, yeah,
brothers,
familia, esposas,
familia, una familia grande.
Okay.
Y ya tienen un tiempo, right, tocando.
Bueno, mis amigos, nosotros tenemos alrededor de 10 años con todos los integrantes de los Rodríguez de Nuevo León. Y pues de antemano, muchas gracias a todos y cada uno de ustedes por su colaboración. Y pues les doy las más infinitas gracias a todos los muchachos Rodríguez de Nuevo León que me han dado la oportunidad de ser un integrante más de ellos, ¿verdad? Pues con el tiempo, pues vamos avanzando como todo. Y pues nosotros somos
los Rodríguez de Nuevo León.
Hasta yo nada diciendo los Rodríguez. Yo también soy. Y su papá, right, señor Juan. Don, ¿cómo se siente tener sus hijos tocar con usted?
Sí, mira, esto no me lo esperaba yo. Estaban chiquitos todos y nunca pensaba que iba a andar con ellos así, tampoco yo de andarles animando así el grupo, ¿verdad? Pero ahora que ya los tengo aquí, que andamos en esto, doy gracias a Dios que andamos ahí todos juntos. Y las nueras, todos aquí andamos, todos, compadre, todos aquí. Ya andamos, compadre, echándole ganas, para adelante.
Sí, así es, y pues de antemano, ¿verdad? Estos 10 años de trayectoria musical, pues de hecho, ¿verdad? Ellos empezaron con nosotros bien pequeños y pues vamos avanzando a través de los años y pues estamos logrando un sueño que se está haciendo realidad.
Oh, that's beautiful. Nice. Está bonito, Ray, que todos toquen juntos. Y,
en familia, es un bonito.
Sí, es una organización familiar que pues estamos todos juntos. Nos platicamos, nos apoyamos y pues vamos para adelante.
Y tocan bien, tocan muy bien.
Muy bien.
We alright.
We're okay, no, sí, tocan bien. Y apenas en estos días están tocando en Plaza México, ¿verdad?
Yes.
En los restaurantes.
Yes, sir.
Y hay muchos americanos también, ¿verdad?
Sí, mucha gente anglosajona que pues está apoyando mucho la música norteña y más que todo, ¿verdad? Pues, como nosotros tenemos varios temas que pues al estilo de los Rodríguez de Nuevo León y pues les gusta mucho este estilo de la música norteña.
And it's called the Plaza México Tour.
Plaza México. That's what I was gonna ask. Yo preguntar. I was like, yo estaba mirando que andaban tocando en all the Plaza México.
Plaza México Tour for everybody.
Okay.
¿Y cuánto les faltan?
Casi tres más. Yo creo que tres más.
Okay.
¿Y cómo les va eso? Like, how is it? Porque están jugando, están tocando en un restaurant, right?
Yes.
So cómo es eso? Like, how is that environment?
It's kind of hard because there'll be times that the restaurant's small. Mm-hmm. So we had to fit our way in there, and we're a bunch of people.
Yeah.
So we had to find where to put the engineer, where to put the speakers, where to put the drummer, especially the drummer.
Yeah.
The drummer takes the whole part of the stage. And the percussionists take everything.
Wow.
It's a lot of stuff.
So at every event that you guys go, you guys also take your engineer
as well?
The
speakers, the engineers,
our
instruments. Yeah, because we want to put a good show out there, not like, you know...
Any other small
little setup, but good setup. But you know, we don't put that much lights, but we put good sound.
No,
and
nice.
We think our good engineer that you know.
No, so yeah, Benito.
He killed it.
Yeah, Benito.
He killed it today. He
Benito
did a great job.
Gallo Blanco.
Y nos falta Luis. Luis apenas se fue, right?
Yes, Luis. We're missing one more. Luis.
Luis es torto, hermano.
Gallo Negro.
No, está bien, man. Y ustedes tocando como familia tanto tiempo. Yo sé que a veces no es fácil también, ¿verdad? Porque como hermanos también, yo tengo dos otros hermanos y que a veces tocamos ahí cabezas y todo. Pero, se mira que tiene una relación buenísima.
Yeah, it's all about family. Mr. Gael Rojo, that's my son.
Es tu hijo también, ¿verdad?
So, we actually came into the band. I got to know Joel and Adrian. It was about 7.5 years ago when we met them. And... me and Adrian, we didn't click. I was like, that first day, I was like, no. Guess what? We did another show. Because I've been doing this for 35 years. I've worked for anybody who is anybody. Anybody that sees me, they know, hey, that's Benny. Benny's done sound for everybody and their mother.
Right.
The second day I met Adrian, I figured it out. He's just like me. We clicked ever since then. We've never looked back.
Yeah.
He thought I was a mean guy.
They brought my son in to be their full-time percussionist, and then I came in, and it is family.
Mm-hmm.
Because I wouldn't be here if it wasn't all about family.
Exactly.
So, we treat each other with respect.
Yes.
And bottom line, that's what gives you longevity, is it's all about family.
Mm-hmm. And I like that whenever we were doing also the live, I love that you guys also have that connection, that you guys know when to turn it off, let's be for real now. Let's get to it.
It's like
when the tiempo es tocar, es vamos a tocar.
Anybody who knows me, they're like, that's the grumpy old man. When he says it's time to go, it's time to go. And don't get me wrong, it's not that I'm a grumpy old man. It's 35 years. Trust me, I've been with everybody who is anybody in this industry.
Right.
And he was a rock star back then,
No, I started in the English music. I started in the 80s hair band rock industry before I moved into the Latin industry and
all that.
Like I said, it's been 35 years.
It's been a roller coaster.
And I've had the opportunity to work with whoever I wanted to work with.
Right.
And, it's all about family.
At the end of the day.
You see, I robbed them. Another person. I'm not gonna say your name, but I went to one of their gigs and then we connected. Boom, I took them. That's all I had to do, just rob them. Yeah. But the thing about us is that we have, with all of us, we look mad,
but really not mad.
You guys are humble.
We have a strong face. Like, we look like...
No, you guys are really
humble. We're very, very humble.
Yeah. No, see,
oh, yes.
Like I said, it's all about family. We're very humble. And if we do get into an argument, we know how to straighten it out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We know how to move on.
Right.
And it's actually, they have adopted me. I'm like the uncle.
See? You're Tio Benny.
Yeah.
Tio Benny.
That's dad, I'm Tio, and then it's the kids.
And otra cosa que voy a preguntar es, like, when did Joel start singing? ¿Cuándo comenzó Joel a cantar? ¿O cómo supieron que Joel iba a ser vocalista?
Well, me and my brother started first, an older brother that I had. His name was Johnny Rodriguez. Shout out to Johnny Rodriguez.
Shout out to Johnny.
Me and him started off. So Johnny started off in the accordion.
Okay.
And he told me, hey, you know, I'm going to play the accordion, but I need somebody to play the guitar.
Uh-huh.
Or the Paul Sesto. So we went to the pawn shop right here in Plant City, bought a cheap guitar that was like $100. And man, I thought it was a Paul Sesto. I'm like over here throwing some Paul Sesto moves on that guitar. And it was a guitar. And I'm like, oh man, what am I doing? So my dad met some people and he was in that band.
Okay.
That the other people were playing in. And they showed us how to, Inspiración Norteño. So we were with them. But he showed me how to play the bajo sexto. And then my other brother, Johnny, you know, he went through it, but he didn't go all the way.
Uh-huh.
So then Joel came in the line playing the accordion. How old are you?
12.
12.
He was like 12-year-old.
Yeah.
Burning accordion. Wow. It was like this big.
But I wasn't supposed to touch it, though.
It was our brother's accordion. They wouldn't let him touch it. They wouldn't let him touch it.
Wow. Y también todo el otro hermano, Daniel, él también canta, right?
You know, oh, yeah. Yeah, so me and Joel started next, and we started with his band that he had.
Uh-huh.
He had a band back then that was called Inspiración Norteño. And they were other people, older people. I don't know if you want to talk about that.
Pues sí, de antemano, fue una larga trayectoria con los otros integrantes de Inspiración Norteña. Y pues nosotros ya andábamos en este ambiente musical. Y pues ellos, ¿verdad?, empezaron con nosotros pequeños a ver el ambiente que traíamos nosotros ya, porque andábamos en muchos lugares de aquí en los Estados Unidos.
Uh-huh.
Y pues nos gustó la ocasión de que ellos nos siguieran.
Sí.
Y nos miraban, ¿verdad?, y se integraron Adrián, Joel, Denio, Luis. Y pues de allí fuimos creciendo. Fuimos creciendo juntos con el estilo musical que traemos ahorita. Y pues ahorita, como les menciono, estamos ya a este nivel.
Sí,
más infinitas gracias de que me dieron la oportunidad de seguir con ellos, porque los otros integrantes musicales de Inspiración Norteña, todos se fueron yendo por sus distintos caminos.
Uh-huh. Sí,
okay. Y pues de hecho, pues me quedé con ellos, ¿verdad? Me dieron la oportunidad de empezar otra trayectoria que estamos siguiendo.
No, está bien, nice. Está bien. Y usted y este señor Juan, el papá de los muchachos, ¿cuántos años tienen que se conocen?
Pues tenemos alrededor como yo casi estoy seguro que tenemos como 15 años, wow. 20 años de conocernos, porque mi compadre Juan, de hecho, es mi compadre.
Mi compadre Juan.
Somos los dos Juanes.
Se juntaba con un amigo integrante de la agrupación y él tocaba las percusiones, Miguel, y nos juntábamos todos ahí en su lugar de él, en su casa, a práctica y hacer barbecue, carne asada, y él pues llevaba a los muchachos.
Okay.
Cuando nosotros estábamos ahí todos juntos, tocando canciones, música norteña, y pues tenemos como 15 años
de
trayectoria que nos conocemos muchos años.
Okay.
La historia de los Rodríguez.
Sí. Y señor Juan,
sí.
Tiene sus tres güeras que también que tocan.
Oh, sí.
Tienen Brisa, la esposa de Luis, ¿verdad? También ella andaba parte del grupo.
Son cuatro ahorita, cuatro nueras.
Cuatro.
Oh, the new one.
Behind the cameras.
Behind the cameras.
Sí.
Is he going to be part of the group too?
Y aprovechando,
New drummer.
Quiero también darle las gracias a mi esposa que está por allá, pues que me dio 5 hijos.
Wow.
Y somos que tengo 5 hijos puros hombres. Y pues aquí los traigo. Digo, mucha gente se queda sorprendida. Dice, ¿cómo le haces? ¿Cómo le haces? Porque no se te...
van para otra cosa, hacer otra cosa, y uno de droga, todo eso, uh-huh. y otra de que, bueno, yo nomás le digo, platicamos, eso es todo lo que hago, y es todo, y ahí andan. Ajá.
Buenos muchachos, son buenos muchachos, y se mira que lo está creyendo
bien, una buena
manera, humildes, ¿no? También como Denise, también, you know, yo andaba hablando con Denise antes de hacer, you know, el video, ella dice, vamos a hacer este día, y, you know.
Let's talk about Denise.
Bien responsable, Denise.
Yeah, let's how do you keep, now you are the, let's say, manager of them, right? Yes, you get everything together. You get everything together and stuff. Like, she was giving out shirts earlier, and in my head, I'm like, how do you keep up with all them? Like, how do you do it? Like, well, give us a little life. Little day in the life of Denise.
I don't keep up with them. I don't know.
How did you become their manager?
Not by choice. That's for sure. I was forced to be HR because they needed somebody to organize them, get their promotions, mm-hmm. you know, the contracts, answer the phones. That's all I do. It's right. Answer phone calls. Contracts.
I was a manager back then.
And
I got kicked out.
And they basically said, hey, it's when Brisa came in, Adriana came in the band. They're like, okay, they're coming in
right.
as wives. They're like, I was the wife first.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, Denise, you were always with us. Hey, you want to be HR manager?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, I only manage my job, you know.
We have experience.
Band, you know?
Yeah.
And yeah, and after that, I just started, like, Adrian would teach me and taught me what I do know. And I've just opened my mind and just kept going.
Right.
And all the booking goes towards you, right? All the bookings with
all the
booking, yes.
Yeah. That's a big responsibility.
Yeah. And she's our shirt. Shirt decal person.
Like,
anybody
shirts.
Wants a shirt, let us know. We have shirts.
Yeah, we have
for sale.
Yeah, no, all the promotion. Business cards, pictures,
flyers,
photo shoots, mm-hmm. video shoots, contracts,
yeah.
phones, English, Spanish, translate, collect the money, get like
everything.
I do it all.
And all this was possible because of Denise.
Yes.
I've been doing the whole communication with Denise. You know, with the we did a photo shoot with the group, and we did this live performance in the pod, and she was very responsible, you know, keeping me up to date. She's like, hey, are we still good? Hey, are we still, you know, what time are we going to be here? I was like, yeah, but so, yeah, well, thank you, you know,
thank
for
you
taking
for
care of
I
these
try,
guys.
I
yeah.
try.
And Brisa, how long have you been playing with the group?
I think I started back in 2020.
Oh, wow. So
yeah,
almost.
So right when I started dating Joel is when I kind of joined the band. I've been playing the accordion since I was 17, so I'm 23 now. So a few years, I started on an app just by playing on the app. My dad bought me an accordion, and then that's when I started playing at home. And then I met René de la Fuente, and he actually was my teacher for a few months, and he taught me what I know at the start. And then I couldn't afford to go to the classes anymore with him. So then I just went back home and did it on YouTube, and then that was pretty much it. I did start with a band, Grupo Noble,
mm-hmm.
so shout out to them. I started off with them, and then that's when I started dating Joel, and then I kind of went
towards
him.
Joel.
So, yeah, because he played the accordion
so
too.
Te invitó Joel para ser parte del grupo?
No, I don't.
I brought her in.
Let's
make it clear. I brought her in.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
You brought all the girls in.
But well, that's kind of cool. Tu cuñado wants you to
yeah.
be part of the group, you know?
Yeah, he did ask. Yeah, he was like, do you want to be a part of the band? I was like, yeah.
I remember the first time she got on stage to play with us.
Oh, yeah?
I turned around. It's in Plant City at the Army. Remember, Justin? I turned around and said, who the hell is this? Who said she can get on my stage? And I was like, well, okay, she's pretty good.
Yeah.
Next thing I know it. These two are a couple, and oh, yeah, she's going to be the new yeah. accordion player. What is
So Adrian was the mastermind behind everything
yes,
then.
Yes.
Yeah, basically.
And we didn't click.
Mm-mm.
Me and Brisa didn't click
no,
at first.
No, we had a lot of issues.
And we had to work it out, I'll tell you this.
Yeah. That's nice.
But it was all worth it.
Face to face.
Yeah, we were going into it, but now... That's my brother.
Yeah,
that's beautiful.
It's nothing but love now.
Yeah,
that's
nice.
Beautiful. And, well, guys, thank you for letting us be a part of the live performance. You know, we did that with the Aga Productions,
mm-hmm.
and I think that was great that we got to collab finally, right?
Finally.
You know?
finally we got everybody together in one room, right?
Yeah. Oh yeah.
And
what happened?
Oh, I don't know. I you pointed the mic that way. Oh, yeah.
So I want to, Justin, he's the youngest one, the youngest brother, right? Daniel's the youngest brother, right? Is he like the newest member of the group? Are you been with them for a while?
I've been playing with the Rodriguez for like since I was 13.
Oh wow, okay, yeah, 13. Yeah.
And did you learn?
How old are you now?
21.
Oh wow,
yeah,
almost 10 years.
Yeah. And how do you like playing? Do you like playing the drums?
It's my life. It's what that's me.
Yeah, you kill the drums. And you're also vocals.
And vocalist.
The teacher. Uh-huh.
I know, I kept seeing you when he was doing the drums. You're like, yeah. I was like, yes.
Joel's my teacher.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Joel, who's his teacher?
Who's your teacher?
I don't know. Aiden.
YouTube.
Yeah,
YouTube.
YouTube.
I was Game Freak at first. And then my mom said, Joel, I need you to get him out the house, man. You can't be doing this.
So, battery again.
He was playing a lot of Call of Duty. Call of Duty, he knew all his guns on there.
Oh, my God.
Yeah,
he
was getting pretty bad. Yeah.
That's cool.
Oh, my God. We'll and then you're one. Like, nah. So you got him into drums?
Hey, he didn't want to play. He was mad.
Thank you so much.
Joel would bring him to the... We have a barn where we practice at.
Right.
And all our drum stuff in there. And he would get mad when we took him in there to play. Yep. We had to force him in there. Locked the door up with Joel, and we started playing.
Till I saw my first payment, my first gig.
Oh, and then you're like, okay. Hey, tell him what your first payment was.
Bag of candies. A bag of candies.
A big, big bag of candies.
He's a baby brother, y'all. Just like
10 years old. Bag of candies. Oh, okay. Yeah.
And then tell him your next one.
The next one was 20, 40, 60, till when, like, you know.
But that's a lot of money for a 10-year-old.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh yeah.
I was in 6th grade buying my own shoes.
It was balling.
Period. Awesome. See, buying my own shoes. There you go.
Yeah, I paid my kid $50 to come record.
But then I didn't start singing until I was 19 years old.
Wow.
Okay. I was like, man, I want to be like my brothers.
Oh, yeah. That's amazing, that brotherly love. Uh-huh.
Oh, I love that.
And Alexis is the newest member, right?
He's coming.
And he's going to be in vocals as well, vocalist, right?
Yes.
And how did you guys find Alexis?
Well,
are my cousins.
You guys are cousins?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yes.
I'm the cousin.
Okay. I should have said that. I'm the giggle.
We're gonna make them learn an instrument too.
Yeah, you were saying you're gonna like
because make them learn. Everybody's band has to learn an instrument.
Yes. Yes,
gotcha. Even Denise.
Get in there with the maracas.
The maracas. So, how does it feel playing with your cousins, Alexis?
Feel thankful for them giving me an opportunity for being in band with them.
That's awesome, man. That's awesome. Yeah, y'all should have just told me he was your cousin. I seen him over there by the food, and I'm like, oh, this guy really loves the music because he's just there the whole time. And then we're doing the pod, he's gonna be here, and I'm like, oh, he's a new member. He should have been here the whole time. Oh, that's good. That's dope.
What do we got?
Just like Brisa, this guy gets on stage all day, and I'm like, who is this guy? Who said he could get on my stage? That's my stage. I am the one in charge of the sound. I am the one in charge of the stage. So I'm like,
Papa Joe.
This guy on stage. So I let him go, and I'm like, hey, that's her cousin. Oh, that's it. So when I did come into the band, I just wasn't the sound engineer. I've been a mentor for this band in a whole bunch of different ways. As soon as he met me, I already started mentoring him. So it just comes with the job.
Yeah.
You're a role model. You know, you look out for the guys. And
you've been in it for a long time, too.
He's been everywhere with us.
Right. I play bass guitar. I started playing bass when I was 15 years old. So I started doing sound when I was 20 years old. So...
Yeah,
yes.
That's a long time. Yeah.
And also, I had a question for el papá de los pollitos. Hey, señor Juan, sí. Don Juan, digo, ¿de qué parte de Nuevo León son?
Bueno, yo soy de un pueblito del mero sur de Nuevo León, del último al sur de Nuevo León, que se llama Mieri Noriega, Nuevo León. Okay. De ahí somos nosotros, mi papá y mi mamá que están por aquí. Y todos, somos 12 hermanos, yo.
Oh, wow.
Somos 6 mujeres y 6 hombres.
Oh, wow.
Pero es que en aquel tiempo no había televisiones. ¿Sí? Yo no. Y así por eso, somos 12. Él es el mayor, el que está aquí. Él es el mayor.
Okay.
Él es el mayor, mi hermano mayor, él. Okay. Y ya siguen otros por ahí. Por aquí viven también, todos estamos aquí.
Todo aquí el plenty.
Ajá, todos estamos por aquí. Y así, y nos venimos para acá. Mi papá nos trajo en el 88 por ahí. Wow. Él fue el que ayudó a mi papá a traernos para acá.
No, está bien.
Fue el que nos trajo para acá. En esa troca Ford, en esa azul.
En esa Ford.
Que está ahí, venía hasta sentada para atrás, donde veníamos como 8 atrás. Con camper y todo ahí. Ahí veníamos.
Entonces, esa troca tiene historia.
No, no, esa troca tiene historia.
Wow.
Digo, si la troca hablara, quién sabe qué diría. Pero sí, como que es todo. Y bueno, como te digo, hay mucha historia que contar. A lo mejor no acabamos toda la noche.
Sí.
Pero eso es lo bonito de contar las historias.
No, sí. Yo sé que tienen demasiadas historias, Ray. Uh-huh.
Muchas historias.
Y sus tocadas también, ¿verdad? You know, pero es algo lindo, es algo.
Y les iba a preguntar también su propia canción de ustedes mismos. ¿Planean hacer
una canción?
It's coming out. It's on the works.
Okay.
We're getting that to maybe next year or maybe this year we'll come out with some new songs.
Yeah. Okay.
Because right now we're doing covers.
Right.
By then, by next year or this year, we'll have the new songs coming out.
Yeah, you guys are very talented, man. You guys.
Thank you.
Not just to say that you guys are.
That way we can move more further up.
Yeah. Not just because we're working for you today. I'm saying that. No, I mean it. Like, I'm being honest. Like, you guys did amazing. You know, when I heard the vocals, I was like, who is that group?
Yeah, a lot of people be surprised.
Yeah.
So it is.
No, I didn't say that. No. I heard it, and my wife's like, who is that? She's like, it's them. I was like, oh.
Yeah, because we asked him to play for it.
Yeah.
Because I couldn't hear you guys. We couldn't hear the instruments. So he was like, come here. And I put on the headset. And I think Brisa looked at me and I was like, oh my God, you guys sound great. Y'all sound really, really good.
Yeah, it's the technology that we have now, because back then we were like little small little mixers. We couldn't do none of that back then. And now that we have all this new stuff, barely getting new stuff, we could do all this.
Yeah, nice.
You guys should have, also, I was going to ask, are you guys ever planning to like tour Mexico, tour Nuevo León?
Oh, we're trying to get to there, but we just, we have to plan it out first to be able to get to all that.
Yes, sit down with
everybody and see what we could do, because we have some people married and some have kids.
Yes, it's a big
responsibility to have everybody go.
That would be pretty cool, though. You know, that would be to play to the motherland.
Oh, yeah.
We do play at my dad's pueblo sometimes.
Oh, really?
Oh, wow. Yes. Okay. I think Joel was telling us that last time.
Yeah, so we do play there.
Sí, allá fue donde tocaron una vez en junio.
13 de junio.
Se hace una fiesta allá.
13 de junio.
El 13 de junio es una fiesta patronal ahí del pueblo que se festeja al señor San Antonio, parece, ¿verdad?
Ajá.
Y dura 3-4 días la fiesta. Uh-huh. Y allí un primo que vive allá, fue el que los animó, dijo, vamos, y él le dijo a la que coordina todo ahí los eventos, le dijo, ¿sabes qué? Traigo unos primos que acaban de llegar de por allá, del norte, por allá.
Y no saben muy bien el español.
Y no saben nada de hablar español, dijo, pero ellos quieren cantar, y que nos sube ahí, y no, pues ahí les hicimos un buen show a la gente que se quedó mirando. Digo, ¿cómo saben cantar si no saben hablar español? Digo.
Selena, right?
Yeah. We always got bullied by that.
Same here.
Sí.
Y mucha gente sí, ¿por qué te chuman? De primero, sí.
Todavía no. Pero sí saben.
Mucha gente hablaba.
No,
no hablaban bien español, y el otro, le digo, José, son de aquí, digo, debe entender mucho la gente a veces. No hace mucha gente, no entiende, pero bueno.
No, sí, más aquí en Plant City, hay mucha raza, pero mi hermano de escuela tiene que saber en inglés, y es duro, no saber dos idiomas, pero también cantar, right?
Es duro hacer las dos.
Mucha gente cuando comenzamos... nos dijo, entre ellos dijo, no, no van a hacer nada, no van a llegar a ningún lado, ¿eh? Porque como, ¿verdad? Como se oían, ¿verdad? Dijo, no, esto no van a llegar para arriba. Y ahora nos miran y se quedan sorprendidos.
Sí, sí, y ahora sí. Mira, están haciendo una gira de Plaza México. Plaza México Tour.
That's crazy. Yo también los he visto en los truck shows, uh-huh. En trocas, y han tocado bien, you know, animan a la gente, you know, it's just...
Oh, les iba a preguntar también de Strawberry Festival, how was y'all's gig there? Did y'all have fun? Did it get packed?
It was one for the books for sure. It was amazing. It was, I think it was all of our first times being at an event like that. I mean, typically it's more Americanized. So for us to be called out to ask to perform that, it got packed. I really didn't expect it to get so full, but mm-hmm. a lot of family, friends, and just other people that came out to support. We really appreciate all the support that we get, and we're so thankful.
And we were nervous too.
I was super nervous.
They were nervous. I had to tell them, don't look at the people's eyes. Okay, look at their eyebrows.
Justin had to go back and talk to him because he comes to me and says, they're all nervous. For me, it's nothing new.
Right.
I've been on stages, events way, way bigger than that.
Right. I mean,
where you have 5,000, 6,000, 8,000 people. So Justin saying, oh, they're all nervous. Tell them to do this. Basically, I went in there. I took control of everything. This is where you're going to go. This is what I need. This is what's got to happen. And,
right. And, this is how it's going
to
do it.
And they enjoyed it. And it was an experience for them. But there's more experiences to come.
Oh, yes.
A lot more.
Yes. I expect to see a lot from you guys. So.
We're sharing mics. We lost. Yeah. No, yeah. But that, es un orgullo grande para tocar en la feria. You know, they're like, I think... Estaba mirando que les llegó. How many people? 600,000.
Yeah.
600,000 llegó este año a la feria.
Wow.
Entre las dos semanas, 600,000 people. So.
I think that would be a record, I think, for Plant City.
Yeah.
Strawberry Festival.
It was over
600,000
people that attended the Strawberry Festival.
That goat was playing. The goat was playing the whole time we're doing the live.
That event.
We want to say sorry about the goat in the background because there's a goat back there screaming.
That event had two guys that were actually running the stage.
Oh, my God.
And there are two guys that have been in the industry for over 50 years.
Mm-hmm.
And they were like, this was the best band out of the whole entire event that they did. At the same time, there was not one seat. It was
full
packed, completely, and people standing.
Yeah, nosotros miramos los lives de Don Pedro.
Yeah, we were seeing Don Pedro's live. Yeah, I was like, okay, I was like, look at them. Y'all look so good, though. Y'all did a really good job.
And Brisa, how does it feel to have your dad support, you know? Because I see your dad goes with the tour.
My parents are there everywhere we go. Like, they've probably once or twice that they missed a gig out, but they try to be there every single time. And it's just a blessing. It's really a blessing. I'm so thankful to God to have the support that I have with my parents.
Mm-hmm.
They're just always there, and it feels amazing. It really does.
Nice.
Shout out to Don Pedro.
Yeah.
He made some amazing tacos.
Yes, he did. And quesadillas.
Pedro's tacos. I got here, and he's like, hey, you know we had to make you food. I said, all right. All right. I'll take three.
I was like, okay. Chill
out. And Adrian, and how does it feel to play with all your brothers, man?
It feels great because there's days that we fight, and by the next second we're over it. But like if we're all family, so we all do fight, but we get over it. There's times that we'll be like, hey, you know, we gotta talk about this, calm down, this and that. But it's all great, you know. I have them all here, you know. I'm proud of them, proud of myself because you know I changed person too.
That's awesome.
I was a mean person back then.
Were you?
Yeah,
you don't look like it.
I'll bully them. I was told we had to do this that day, and I pushed them hard.
Yeah.
But look at
we did a Georgia tour one time.
Oh wow.
Oh wow.
We did like three days in Georgia. We had like two nightclubs in one day, and the same day we had to go to a salon and play as well. So I was working them hard back then, you know. But now it's more relaxed. Where we have our man, I don't have to deal with that no more. I have my manager. We have a manager here. Where
AKA your wife,
HR, AKA wife.
That means like
you know.
and Justin, how long have you guys known Justin for?
I've been with them for 8, 7.5 years. Me and my dad.
Nice,
that's awesome, man.
We met them down in Clueston at a gig, and And like they said, they didn't click at first, but after that, everything was good.
And how do you feel having your dad along with you when you go to your gigs and stuff?
That's the man right there.
That's a man, huh?
That's the man. He's the one that got me in the music, you know.
My familia, you know, todo de músicos.
Okay.
So and he pushed me. He's the one that made me learn how to play the congas.
Oh, really?
Yeah. He had a band back in the day, mm-hmm. and the percussion player, he left to go do something else. And he's like, it's your time to shine.
So like this.
Then I started playing, and I got really good. And then I got in with Adrian, and the rest is history. I've been here forever now.
Nice. Awesome. I like that.
And Joel, how's it feel playing with your brothers?
It feels good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, like sometimes I will have to, I have to teach them the right way how to do it. Eventually, by now, they pretty much got it.
That's nice.
They don't really need me to teach them all that. But sometimes I'm going to have to learn his spot too if he ain't able to come or able to go. Yes. Or Daniels. It's like sometimes
be there.
Like sometimes they'll take
always.
Day off.
Okay.
Some of them take a day off and I'll have to take their spot for the day.
Okay. That's what I was gonna ask. Like how do you like when y'all guys got gigs but somebody has something to do, do you guys have to
We talk to HR.
We have a
request day.
You get written up if you're not on
the No, she told him the day of the photo shoot. Yeah.
You should see some of our write-ups. This guy got like six write-ups. And we still haven't fired him yet. Six write-ups.
And, oh my gosh. What are the write-ups for?
Different things. Like some days he forgets something or he's late.
But he comes from far away.
Yeah, he does. He does come to like from Bradenton.
Yeah.
But he was closer. He's from Ruskin.
Oh, okay.
And then he moved to Bradenton. Now he's trying to move back.
and Joelle, you also play with your wife, you know, with the group. How do you see, you know, the relationship with your wife and your brothers? Is it like, you know, because I know like we're at family cookouts, right? You know, you bring your wife to the family. You know, she's a little shy. But it looks like you guys all have just a great relationship.
She's one of the guys.
She's definitely one of the guys.
Yeah.
When you're in a band, it's different. Because when you're in a band, we're one. Mm-hmm. And everybody here has a certain job to do. Without one person, then we're not who we're supposed to be.
Right.
She's one of the guys.
Yeah. Yeah, I seen that earlier. She looks back, she's like, It don't sound that way. You know what I'm saying? I was just telling someone. But that's good, the relationship you guys all have.
Y'all have a like, good dynamic that you guys got going on, you know?
So what else can we see coming soon for Los Rodriguez? I know you guys said you guys have a original song coming out too, right?
Yes, we're going to come out with songs originals. Right now we have a new logo that we're showing out there with new shirts.
Okay, okay.
Out there. We had an older logo, but now we came out a newer one that's going to have our new shirts.
Okay.
And just more gigs out there and see where we can tour from and go to different places.
Awesome, awesome. And the style of music you guys are playing is Norteño music, right?
Yes, Norteño sax.
Sax, okay. That's awesome, man. Yeah.
But sometimes we focus more on Norteños,
mm-hmm.
and then we go to Norteño sax too.
Sax, okay, yeah. You guys get down with the cumbias and the huapangos.
Yes.
You know. I love y'all's
huapangos.
I was getting back.
She was dancing behind the camera. And I was like, stop. You know, but it's awesome, man. And guys, you know, once again, thank you guys for being on. Mm-hmm. Muchas gracias. You know, it was a pleasure having all of you guys.
It's a lot of you guys. I feel like we're in school, guys.
Oh, yeah. We're a bunch of, we're missing one more person. We're missing our sax person, Luis.
Luis.
Yeah. We're missing Pelucha, too.
No, but you guys are doing great. Están tocando bien y muchas bendiciones.
And like I said, we're a big family. We're missing Luis. We're missing Brisa's dad and her mom. Mm-hmm. They come to the shows.
That's awesome.
So we're just missing them three. And I think who else? Anybody else know, right? And Bertha, Benny's wife. And she always comes to the show.
He's married.
Oh yeah.
Benny Blanco.
Well, I only have one single person. Who's the single person?
Justin.
Ladies, I hear that.
Y'all hear that. Justin's single, ready to
meet. He might be late to
Justin, so he can see you.
He might be late to your date, but he's ready.
Stand up, Justin, so he can see you. Put the phone
phone number.
Oh, and the one behind the
what's her name? What's her name? If you guys don't mind asking.
Eileen. We got Eileen. Shout out to Eileen.
We are hiring if you're looking for a job. No, but this is awesome, man.
She's probably the Rodriguez. She's already
taken.
She's like, don't take her.
Yeah. No, she's killing me.
HR. But what else do we have? What else do we have to look forward for you guys? Like, do you guys have any upcoming shows coming up that you guys want to talk about? ¿Dónde van a estar next por su próximo show?
Unas tocadas.
Pues sí, tenemos varios proyectos que vienen, ¿verdad? Y tenemos unas tocadas que cumplir. Mm-hmm. La próxima presentación va a ser en La Legacy Nightclub en Winter Heaven.
Okay.
Y tenemos otro Plaza México en Lakeland.
Uh-huh.
Y tenemos otro otra tocada que vamos a cumplir y para el sur de aquí de Florida.
Okay.
Y pues tenemos varios proyectos en que vienen y pues todos juntos pues vamos a lograrlo.
Sí, todos juntos.
¿Y cuál día Plaza México? ¿Tú sabes?
April 12th.
¿Es Saturday? We'll be there.
Lakeland. You want to sit in Lakeland?
Yeah.
Okay.
We'll be there, guys.
We'll be there.
Hey, that's a blast going there.
I'm going to buy everybody shots.
Yeah. It's 10 to 1.
First round on me.
Last time, the last one we played at Plaza Mico,
don't drink.
We lasted till like 2 in the morning.
Don't drink.
Yeah, that's good.
Y'all guys don't drink?
The drummer doesn't drink.
That's good.
Lisa doesn't drink.
Uh-oh.
Justin doesn't drink. Benny doesn't drink.
That's good. Well, I'll get virgin shots.
Yeah,
we'll get virgin shots.
Virgin watermelon
shots.
I drink, though. I do drink.
He likes shots.
You, my boy Benny, cigarettes if you want to give him a cigarette.
Oh,
wow. Marvel shorts.
These guys are bad.
And how do you like being with their group? Like, when you first came in, I know you and Adrian didn't click at first, but after that, how is it being with them? Like, how do you click with them?
You got to understand where I come from.
Mm-hmm.
To understand first. You know, I come from a family of musicians.
Mm-hmm.
Long, long line of musicians. My grandfather's, his grandfather, his dad, my uncles, where I started with them. And,
mm-hmm.
and they recorded with Freddie's Records. They were a well-known band back in the 80s and the 90s. They were an established Tejano Chicano band back
right.
in that era. So my bloodline, it goes way back.
Mm-hmm.
It's all about family.
Yeah.
I've worked with a lot of bands. I was a longtime engineer for Bajo Cero. I worked with Comando. I've worked with all kinds of bands. Every once in a while, Legacia, Norteña calls me. They want me to work with them. Invasion 360, I've worked with them. I was working with G5 out of Naples.
Mm-hmm.
There's a whole list of people. But it really boils down to family.
Yeah.
Because once we clicked and I understood where they were going and we just stuck together.
Nice.
Because it's something that I enjoy doing.
Because mm-hmm.
I don't have to do it if I don't want to.
Yeah.
But I enjoy what I do. And it just, let's put it this way. The one engineer, if your band has an engineer, he can really make you shine. He can really put you at another level. And then me mentoring these guys, and they've just gotten better and better and better. And it's
us,
just...
Tell us everybody damn when you tell me you can't sound out.
No, I mean, there's a toilet paper and duct tape. Oh, yeah, there's a couple times that when we first started, had to... You're mentoring. You're explaining certain things.
Right.
And Daniel soaks it all in. Every mm-hmm. bit of it, Daniel soaks it.
Daniel's the drummer, guys.
Daniel's at another level right now. From mm-hmm. where me and him met to where he's at now, he's like, wow, way over here now. And I don't have to say anything to him anymore. He knows what time it is. He's learned.
Yeah.
And then, like, Benny will always tell us, oh, you have to buy your brother this. You gotta buy your brother that. You gotta buy your brother this. You gotta buy your brother that. Until you got everything.
Yeah.
You don't have to tell nothing no more.
All I have to say is, hey, we need this, or we need to do this, or we need to do that. And next we'll thing, change it. We're doing it.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
And
you guys are missing.
And they trust me.
Yeah.
Because they have to, there's a trust in it. They've learned to trust me, and true or false that they progressed.
Yeah.
You ask their dad, because he's the one that's sitting back just watching everything. And he's the one that'll tell you. Him and their mom. They'll sit there and they'll tell you, since you came in, we've gone to another level. And it's like that with any band.
Yeah. It takes a team. It takes a team.
Yeah. And, you know, it does, it, like you said, when you have a good engineer and a good mentor behind a group, it all becomes and it all just flows naturally.
And even the engineer, the vocalist, the bajo player, mm-hmm. the accordion player, the sax player, the drummer, dad, dad's doing the intros, Mr. Hernandez also does vocals. Just everything just works. Everything just sounds great.
Back in the 90s, the late 90s, I was one of the founders and the bass player for a band called Suspiro from Ruskin, which they are basically the image of, or they're what made Bajo Cero who they are today. Mm-hmm. Because Bajo Cero used to see that band, and it inspired them to become who they are.
Right.
Suspiro was the hottest Tejano band, period, in mm-hmm. Florida. And a lot of people looked at them. Every band that I've ever been in, I've always been that mentor. And it's because of all the years and
I've seen it, you've learned.
I've done it all. I've worked with all the big people, seen how they do things, learned how they do things. And even to this day, I still learn. Kevin, the Paranda, Porfugo de Nueva León, Kevin, their sound engineer, hands down to him, because I actually worked with him not too long ago, and I stole a couple of tricks.
Oh, that's awesome. And where can we find Los Rodriguez?
Where can we find you guys on social media?
Managers, where can we find you guys?
Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Snapchat, YouTube, all of it.
And if someone wants to hire you guys, how can we get in contact through social media? Is there a number?
There is a phone number where you can either text me, call me, whatever.
I'll put the number right here.
I'll put it right here. It might change tomorrow.
We have that one direct line.
Yeah. Hey, I like when you started texting me, the photos that I took of you guys, it's the, and I was like, damn, that photo looks good.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, I took that photo. You guys did great. And then I see another one, you guys are like facing up. And y'all put, we're always looking forward. I said, yes, you are. No, guys, listen. Thank you so much for being on. And guys, we just shot, 2 hours of shooting?
Yeah.
That's why I look like this, guys. We look rough. I'm sorry. We're still in uniform. And muchas gracias. Bendiciones. Blessings.
Many, many blessings on your gigs, your future gigs, everything. And I wish you nothing but the best.
The best, guys.
Absolutely nothing but the best.
And the same goes for you guys. We're here doing this because of you guys.
Yeah.
Thank you for having us on our podcast.
Yeah, absolutely. For sure, it's been in the works.
Yes. We finally made it.
Yes, we made it happen.
Yeah, when you told me, she was like, hey, after this, we're going to the pod. I said, oh my God. I was like, I forgot my mics. No worries. But you guys are ready.
No worries.
We're ready. We got it. She's like, no, we're always ready. That's going to be our theme, always ready.
Or always looking forward.
Yes.
And we're always improving.
Yes.
Always improving.
And
always improving our equipment, too.
Yes, nice. Yes. And you guys, una vez más, muchas gracias.
Thank you guys so much for everything. Many blessings to you guys.
Gracias por estar aquí con nosotros colaborando en esta noche. Y pues de antemano a todos y cada uno de ustedes, muchas gracias. Nosotros somos Los Rodríguez, de Nuevo León. Gracias.
Good night, everybody.
Haga ruido. Que se escuche ese ruido.
Let me hear you make some noise. Let me hear you make some noise. I got ruido.
Haga ruido.